Today we are going to install on this mysharktutorials.com website, which is which I have hosted with HostGator. I'm going to install a best free page builder plugin for WordPress, and I find this plugin the best because this plugin gives you a lot of features. It allows you to hide even content for unregistered or unlogged in users and many more free features which allows it. It also has a paid version, but I never really used the paid version. I always was using only free version of this plugin, and it allows you to work on front end. It doesn't, you, some plugins, you know guys, they actually draw you to the back end and then you don't really see what you are doing, but this plugin allows you to do everything from the front end, and it allows you to add different features to your pages and many more things. So as in next video, I will show you how you can add fireworks, like firework effect on your website. For example, if you would want to put a firework on any page of your website and it would be shooting, for example you are making some birthday greetings to someone and you would want to add the fireworks on your website, so you will be able to see it in my next video, guys. But now let's go into our dashboard of our site and let's go into plugins and let's install Beaver plugin, guys. Maybe some of you already know this plugin, but I find it to be a best one. So WordPress Beaver page builder, it was already there. As you see, this is WordPress page builder Beaver. Let's install this plugin and I will show you how it works quickly. Let's go around it and activate it, okay? And once this plugin is activated, all you need to do, or you have to go to your site and you can start working on any page. Your page builder is here. And we can go to form. As you remember in my previous video, I created this form where you can save all data and you can collect any data from your users and save it in database and then export to CSV files, and you can add any fields you want to save in your database. Here at the top now you have this page builder. If you click on this, it will activate that page builder and you can start working. You say here no thanks, you can start working with your site. Here it gives you this content area, and if you browse around with your cursor, you can see which content you can edit, and in this case you can edit this content. But the good thing about Hestia theme is that you can remove anything from any page. Like for example, now I have only this option here and I would like to remove, for example, I would like to remove all content area or make it free without this sidebar and so on and so forth, so I can easily do it. So let's close this now, let's publish changes, because I will show you what I mean now. Let's go into edit page, and I'm editing this particular page, and here on the right hand side you see like template and default template. Default template, it is like themes template, and like I said, Hestia is very good because it has like different options. It can give you page builder blank theme. If we click this and update now and we will go back to page, you will see that now page will be blank, like kind of, okay? As you see, there is no headers, no nothing really on this page. It is kind of blank now, and we can even remove it more if we want. Actually, this is my old content which I haven't removed yet. I can remove this content as well from here. This is like from my old installation actually, guys. So yes, you can see that we can pretty much change and remove everything, like navigation and footer and everything from this page. If I go back again now and I will change now to page builder full width theme update, it will give me full width theme but for page builder purposes, but it will leave, like as you see, title on top, it has, and it has this footer at the very bottom. And like I said, I will remove this. I haven't removed this single example page and all this. It is my old site. So yes guys, and now if we activate page builder, you can see now this area which we can work with. If you would want this to be, for example, full width, not here endings, and you click on this kind of key icon, row settings, or you click on it and you say width, not fixed, but you would say full width, okay? And you go into content widths, you as well say it full widths. And as you see, now we already can work with full page of, and we are not limited to some middle part and so on and so forth, guys. And similar you can do with other features here, like you can remove these margins if you don't want, from top, from bottom. You can even put to minus margins, for example, minus 20. Sometimes you need to bring some block up and so on and so forth. So save it, and once you are done editing particular page, you just click done and you click publish changes. And if you would want to add more than one column, for example, then again click on page builder for it, and let's go here on the right hand side. You will see row layouts, and this is how many columns you would want in one row. Actually, for example, in this row I would like to have three columns, so I will grab another two columns and I will bring them here to the side. Okay, and now as you see, I have two columns here and I have third column here. So now I have three columns. But if I would want this column to be in the middle rather than being it on the side, I can simply grab it and drop it in the middle, actually. Okay, and now I have two columns on the side and one column in the middle. And you can do many more things here. You can put like columns underneath, you can put another additional rows, and once you are done editing, just click done and publish changes. And this is it, guys. And you have your page builder, and as you see, this is totally different page now. So yes, guys, if you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you in my other videos.